recently removed the VICS intake manifold from my 99 Miata and put on this JDM square top. If you decide to put it on, you know, a square top on your, you know, car, your Miata right here, and you decide to keep the factory ECM, it's not a good idea. You will lose a lot of power putting that on a 99 or a 2000 with no other changes. I mean, just doing that by itself won't work. But if you got a standalone, it'll work just fine. But what I'm going to show you now, I'm going to show you how the VICS works in the old intake manifold I pulled off. This is the factory VICS manifold. Lay it there for right now. It's, you know, somewhat restrictive. However, it actually has a better low end and mid range than the square top, which I've overcome by reprogramming the computer that I had. But what gives this thing the advantage is it has long runners and it has a resonance chamber. Got the extra butterflies here that basically opens up this chamber to use resonance to push more air in at a specific RPM, which is about 5400 RPM and higher is where they have it set at. I'm going to show you how the computer actually controls it, because my aftermarket is still trying to control something that's no longer there, which doesn't affect the performance or nothing else like that. I've got the engine running and I've got the VICS unit plugged in. I went into my aftermarket EMS and told it to change the settings to 1400 RPMs for display reasons. Normally the factory computer would be set at 5400, but this computer is going to control it at 1400, which means nothing since I'm not really using VICS, but it will be for demonstration reasons. When it's sitting here on idle, you see they're closed, and I've got it set to open up at 1400. Once the RPM gets back down below the set, you know, the factory setting, it closes back up. Kind of a neat little trick. Be a neat little thing to use if you need variable length runners or something like that, but that's pretty much how the VICS works.